Hey everybody, Fire Mama here, and welcome to the video, and thank you for watching, and happy National Preparedness Month. This is like one of my favorite months because I also get to, not that it stops me any other time of the year, but I can get away with, you know, talking to people about being prepared, you know, different ways and different things. And I can say, oh, it's National Preparedness Month. You have to listen to me. No, but really, you know, it just, I like to talk to people as much as I can all the time, you know, about just doing little things to be ready. And so this month, I want to try to do most of my videos on just different ways of being prepared in different kind of parts of the year, you know, we have little emergency kit bags in our vehicles. Well, actually, my daughter and I have a full-fledged jump bag since we're first responders. But, you know, each winter, there's different things in those bags. And I'll show you those than what there is in summer. You know, I'll take a couple things out and kind of change it around for what you need for summer than what you would need for winter, and so on. But anyway, so I do hope you enjoy it. And if you have anything that you guys do, please, by all means, comment or, you know, everybody's going to be kind of different. We're mostly the same in how we are prepared for things, but, you know, some places are a little bit different. Some places are warmer year-round. The rest of us have winter, kind of. They're, you know, somewhat mild. But, you know, so the way we prepare for different things, you know, everybody's different. We come from, you know, all parts of the United States, the world, so we all are a little different. But the first thing I wanted to talk about, now that I'm done rambling on, is the first, and I think it's not really the important, most important, but it's kind of up there, really, really super important on the list, because most people have to have their vehicles. So I am very adamant about, I do not let my truck get below a half a tank. If it does, it is just, you know, minute, because for one, I know a half a tank will get me to the furthest family member that lives away, immediate family member, immediate, because, you know, I have a lot of family members all over the state, and I can't just, it would take more than a half a tank to get to them, and several other states. But my immediate family member, my son, he lives 28 miles from us. And so if I would have to go up there to get him and his family, or, you know, there was an emergency or something, a disaster, I know a half a tank will get me up there and get me home, and I still have some reserve. You know, plus with gas prices, I know it seems funny, they're high, but if you just stay, putting little bits in is easier than, you know, putting in $100 worth when you let it get dry. So, anyway, that's just one thing, because plus, you know, if you lived where you have winters and you're coming home one day in a storm or something happens and you would get stranded, you want that fuel to be able to keep your vehicle running, you know, for heat. And, you know, and if you're leaving one of the places that has hurricanes, and I do hope all is well in Florida. I know it's rough. Well, I don't know. I've never been in a hurricane, but bless those people down there. Anyway, you want to get as far as you can on a tank of gas without having to stop, maybe in the middle of a traffic jam or in chaos or something like that. You just want to be able to keep driving. Anyway, you guys understand. I know you do what I'm talking about. So, you know, and you know, make sure your tires are always good and do your oil changes. And, you know, just take care of your vehicle and it'll take care of you. So, I'm not going to keep going on and on for on that forever, you know how. But also, in my, like I said before, in the vehicles, I like to keep, you know, bags, emergency bags, you know, for, like, if something, I work about 24 miles from home, I have to go back and forth. So if something was to happen to in the middle of winter, you know, and I get off in the ditch or, you know, whatever, you know, I have this bag that it has a little, you know, couple protein bars and etc. In it. But and I'll get one of those bags out and go through it and show you guys, and then I'll show you what I put in for summer, you know, versus winter and this and that. And then plus, now my husband, he does travel a lot, and his bag is a little different from ours because he could end up clear out in Kansas, you know. So his bag is different than mine and my daughter's in a lot of ways. But we all, that is all I'm going to talk about in this video. So just keep your tanks as close to full as you can. You know, and like I say, I know it's hard. Gas prices are amazingly crazy. I believe last was $3.79 here. And, you know, that's kind of, that's a little more than what we're used to paying for. So, I mean, since about, 6 months ago or so, it was down a little bit, but this last few months, it just keeps going up and up and up and up and up more. Anyway, so just take care of your vehicle, and they'll take care of you in your time of need. So, for now, that is all. This is Fire Mama, and I hope everybody has a blessed day. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. If you have not subscribed yet, please consider subscribing and tell your friends and family and everyone. And that's all. Fire Mama out.